A few days ago, I saw a very beautiful rainbow when I looked out of the window of my office. This experience inspired me to make a short video which explains the physics behind the creation of such a rainbow. In principle, the physics of a rainbow is very simple to understand. Before continuing, I want to introduce the term refraction. If a light ray enters a transparent medium, such as water or glass, the light rays do not continue their way according to a straight line, as shown in this picture. Instead, the light ray changes its direction at the surface of the transparent medium. This effect is called diffraction. The direction of the new light ray is directly related to the direction of the incoming light ray and, additionally, to the properties of the medium. When the ray leaves the medium, diffraction happens a second time and the light ray is turned into the opposite direction. In this picture, both surfaces are parallel to each other. Therefore, the direction of the outgoing light is again the same as the one of the incoming light. But due to the diffraction that happens before, there is a parallel displacement of the outgoing light. This effect can be made visible by filling a simple glass with tap water and then inserting an object like a straw or a spoon. Looking into the glass under a specific angle visualizes this displacement by showing a gap between the parts of the object in the air and in the water. In order to explain the phenomena of diffraction, it is necessary to describe light not only as rays in form of straight lines. In fact, the wave model of light has to be taken into account, which states that every part of a light beam is the source of a new light wave. These waves sum up to a new wavefront of light rays as shown on the right side of this figure. These wavefronts travel always with the speed of light. However, the speed of light in the vacuum is different than the speed of light inside a medium. The fraction of both values is defined as the refractive index of a material and is always larger than 1, because the speed of light in the medium must be always smaller than the speed of light in the vacuum. If the light rays enter the medium under a specific angle, then every wavefront reaches the surface of the medium at different timings, and all newly created waves start with a certain time offset. Therefore, the wavefronts of the new waves inside the material are tilted by a specific angle that depends on the angle of the incoming light and the refractive index of the material. However, the refractive index is not constant for all colors but varies for different wavelengths. Blue light has a wavelength of around 300 nanometer, whereas red light has a longer wavelength of around 800 nanometer. The refractive index as a function of the wavelength is shown in this graph. It has a value of around 1.36 for smaller wavelengths at blue light and 1.33 for larger wavelengths in the red area. This means basically that the angle of refraction also becomes a function of the wavelength. This behavior can be seen in the following video. A long and light-tight paper roll is covered with aluminum foil at one side. Inside the foil there is a small hole which lets the light of a flashlight, which is placed on the other end of the roll, pass through. The light rays hit the glass prism, which changes the direction due to refraction. Because the white light of the flashlight consists of all colors from red via yellow, green up to blue, the white light then splits into the spectral colors which can be visualized with the help of a white paper in the far distance from a prism. Here one can see easily the rainbow colors in the spectrum. A real rainbow is created when the light of the sun hits a spherical water drop in the atmosphere. With the help of a simulation program, it can be shown how each light ray of the sun is undergoing a diffraction when passing the surface of one arbitrary water drop. After that, the light ray is reflected on the backside of the water drop and then leaves it at a different position under a different angle. The more light rays we simulate, the more it turns out that due to the geometrical constraints of the round shape, the outgoing rays pile up under a certain angle. This angle can be either calculated analytically with a dedicated formula or measured from the resulting ray trace image. It turns out that the obtained value is very close to 42 degrees. This means a rainbow can only be observed if the angle between the sun and the observer is given as that angle. This is also the reason why the rainbow has always the shape of a bow, because all water drops along this bow have to fulfill the requirement of 42 degrees. If you look very carefully, you will always find a second rainbow above the original one, and you will see that the order of the colors is inverted. The reason for that is simply another reflection on the backside of the raindrop. The condition for this second reflection can also be calculated or simulated and turns out to be 51 degrees, which is slightly larger than the one of the main rainbow. It also appears much darker than the main one just because the intensity of the light decreases during the second reflection. I hope that you find this video informative and hope that I will be able to upload new physics videos very soon. Please subscribe and visit my channel from time to time to see if there is any new content available.